Hey, Dreamy Dreamers, these are your July messages, so stay tuned. Hey, Dreamy Dreamers, welcome back to the Crazy Dreamer Network. My name is AJ, and let's hop right into today's reading. So today's reading is a pick a card on July messages for you, okay, in your career, spirituality, and love, okay? So let's begin. We have four piles, pile number one, pile number two, pile number three, and pile number four. I will let you all meditate on these, but first let's get your crystal selections. We have pile number one with the Amazonite crystal heart, pile number two with the Tektite crystal, pile number three with the Sunstone, and pile number four, we have a Magnesite crystal. So I'll give you all some time to meditate on your pile selections. All right, my dreamy dreamers. Again, we have pile number one, pile number two, pile number three, and pile number four. I love you all so much, and I'll see you in your reading. Bye. Hey, pile number ones. Welcome back to your reading. So before we get to your crystal and your pile selection card, let's shuffle for your reading. If you would all like to skip this portion, your timestamp will be in the description box down below. I've shuffled off camera, so let's begin. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for pile number ones during the month of July. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for our pile number ones during the month of July, Spirit. Thank you, thank you, and thank you. Okay. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for our pile number ones during the month of July. Thank you, thank you, and thank you. Okay, clear, concise, accurate messages, thank you, coming in for our pile number ones during the month of July. Thank you. Then we're going to do one magical spell card, one magic spell card to end pile number one's reading, or one final message from the magical spell card deck for pile number one during the month of July, Spirit. I'm feeling called to this one. Perfect. All right, my lovely dreamy dreamers, let's get into your reading, my loves. Okay, so welcome back. For those of you all who chose this gorgeous blue Amazonite crystal heart, and you all chose the Page of Swords from the Gummy Bear Tarot in regards to your pile selection cards. So let's get into your pile selection cards first. With the Amazonite crystal heart, and we'll put your crystal right there, and the Page of Swords, I feel like messages galore. There are going to be a lot of people keeping their eye on you, pile number ones. I feel like people are very interested in whatever you're doing right now, because of the way in which you're making it look, right? You could be making something look glamorous or beautiful or thrilling, and you might be traveling a lot. So I feel like there's gonna be a lot of eyes on you during the month of July, a lot of people curious about you, and a lot of people keeping tabs on you as well. Some of those people can be air signs, Aquarius, Libra, or Gemini. So, you know, you can take some notes on that, and they could be younger or kind of more of a youthful energy, right? They could really like what they see from you as of right now. So we're gonna put your tarot here. So let's reveal your Green Witch Oracle card. Come on, pile number ones. You cannot make this up, and I did not see these cards before I'm pulling them, so I'm just as surprised as you are. We have card number 31 with luck. I love this. I've been kind of familiarizing myself with this deck because it's new to me, and I have yet to pull this card, either personal personally, doing a personal reading, so for other people, or collectively. So pile number one, expect blessings. Expect what seems like luck to come your way during the month of July, okay? We have card number 31 as well, 3-1, that's 4. I feel like there's gonna be a lot of stability, a lot of groundedness coming in for you during the month of July, pile number one. So congratulations in advance. I believe this sign is Capricorn, and I think that's interesting because in the next few days, so I think July 3rd is the Capricorn full moon, and we start feeling the energy of the full moon a couple of days before it happens and a few days after it occurs. So you could be seeing semblances of this full moon and what it's bringing your way, you know, either just in the recent past or as we speak. Okay, so I'm posting this on June 27th. Some of you all might see it on June 28th, but whatever the case is, luck is on your side. You're very blessed right now, and I feel like you're gonna feel like things are just moving fluidly. You're gonna really feel like, wow, I'm so fortunate to be living the life that I lead. Okay, so congratulations in advance to my beautiful pile number ones. Now I do want to read a little bit of the luck card for you, just because my first time pulling it, and I want to give you all more accurate information about this card. So it says, many things grow in the garden that were never sown there, Thomas Fuller. And it says, oracle meanings. You may find you are right in the middle of a situation at present, or that something is stuck in circles. And this could be because this could be caused by overreactions or too much interference. It's time to let things progress at their own pace. Limes bring luck with them, so take a chance and be ready for the ups and downs this energy brings, but know that time is on your side. Don't overplan and be open to letting complexities unravel on their own. It's really interesting because for the first time, I feel like with a card like luck, you would think that, you know, the message would have just been immediately like just harmonious and like everything's gonna go your way. However, this is kind of the contrary of that. It's not saying that things aren't gonna go your way, because limes bring luck. So they're saying, hey, maybe drink more lime, drink more water with lime, or something like that. But what I'm getting for you, pile number ones, is no, this energy you are evoking is like a lucky girl, lucky boy, lucky person syndrome type energy. And you're going to start seeing blessings and bountiful blessings literally this full moon in Capricorn. And I have not even done a pick a card full moon video yet, but that will be coming out. So stay tuned for that. Okay, pile number ones. But luck is definitely on your side. And there's going to be harmony and awareness taking place with this luck being transpired here. And I also want to say that I feel like you're going to feel a calm before a luck storm. You know what I mean? You're going to kind of feel like, okay, well, why do I feel so relaxed? Why do I feel so chill? Why do I feel so at ease? It's almost like you're questioning it. But in reality, you're going to see why. Almost like your anxieties have halted just for this reason alone, right? To bring more luck and blessings into your life. Okay, so let's begin with your reading. Let's take our first three cards. So we have card number 54 with Virgo. I love it. And as you can see, this depiction of this Virgo is carrying wheat. Wheat has a lot to do with abundance. We have card number 59 with Aquarius, a lot of signs here, a lot of zodiac signs here. And then last but not least, beautiful, we have card number 10 with Oshun. So Oshun is a goddess, you know, a pantheon goddess of the African, of the Orishas. So I feel like there's a lot of blessings coming your way, a lot of beauty, a lot of fertility, a lot of drawing people in with your said beauty, fertility, or your grace, okay, pile number ones. with Virgo here, I feel like there might be something kind of like etheric about you right now or during this time, especially with Virgo and Aquarius energy here. There's a lot of etheric energy. There's a lot of goddess energy within you, pile number ones. And this could be why you're catching a lot of eyes. People are kind of like watching you and wanting to keep tabs on you, because I feel like you just make something look really, really good or really, really tempting. Okay. And with Virgo here, I feel like you are really wanting to become more meticulous in your approach to how you get certain things done. I feel like you can be a more fluid, airy type of individual, hence the Aquarius card here. But with Oshun, I feel like you're drawing luck into you. You're drawing these blessings into you. You're using the goddess approach in regards to receiving abundance, and you're bringing it in. You're attracting it in, is what I'm trying to tell you. And with the Virgo card here, again, like I was suggesting, I think this could be a time to call in more like deliberate approach to your manifestation. So let's say you want to manifest travel, and you want to manifest travel to a tropical island. This is just an example. Let's say with Virgo, how that could be best done, how that could be best manifested, is that Virgos are very practical because they're earth signs. And I feel like when it comes to the Virgin Virgo approach, they're going to do their due diligence. So like more like an air sign or like a water sign, we'll use like our thoughts or our emotions to call things in. Whereas Virgos, they'll start writing it out, right? Maybe journaling. How do you put it? Scripting, right? Scripting how they're going to manifest this travel to the tropical island. Blase. I feel like you could be taking more of a proactive approach like that, more of like an action-based approach. An action-based approach, more of a material approach, pile number ones, than maybe just thinking or dreaming it or feeling it, okay? But you will probably be doing all three. But yeah, so let's get your tarot to gain further insight. We have the Knight of Cups, lovely. We have the Ace of Cups, beautiful pile number ones. We have the Four of Swords. We have the Empress. Yeah, you're definitely magnetic. You're definitely using a lot of goddess energy, no matter what you prescribe to, what gender you prescribe to or anything like that. You're using the feminine energy, the feminine principle to draw things into you right now. There could be someone who's really interested in you or, you know, who wants to charm you. That can be very kind of like, how can I put this? Keeping their eye on you right now, or wanting to offer you some type of love, wanting to offer you some type of like, extend an offer of romance or something to you as well, pile number ones, okay? And then our last card, but not least, Three of Swords. Very interesting. So again, with the Knight of Cups, Ace of Cups, Four of Swords, the Empress, and the Three of Swords, I have a feeling like whatever you have been healing from, you're healed from, okay? Pile number ones, that's what I'm getting. I feel like you're very healed, especially with the Aquarius card. And the Aquarius card is all about healing, is all about a deep healing when it comes to yourself and how to help others heal through the process of healing yourself, right? And with the Knight of Cups, some of you all might be water signs, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. We have like two water elements back to back with each next to each other. So you all might be water signs, or you might have a lot of water placements in your chart. But what I'm getting here is I feel like there could be a proposal on the horizon. There could be someone, something wanting to extend something your way. And I feel like you're really going to be very joyous in regards to this offer that's being extended your way right now, pile number ones. With the Ace of Cups here, I have a feeling maybe you've been calling this in, or maybe you've been practicing a lot of self-love, and through that self-love and devotion to yourself as of recently, pile number ones, it's working. You know, you're calling in a lot of abundant energy because you are filled, you know, your cup runneth over. And what I'm also getting is whatever this offer is, you might be accepting it as well. Okay. So with the Four of Swords here, I have a feeling that maybe there's been so many offers coming your way that you might have to take some time, maybe in the middle of July, to kind of like relax, retreat, get some much needed rest and recovery. And with the Empress card here, I just have a feeling that, you know, the goddess Oshun, so to speak, is really blessing you right now, okay? Is really blessing you right now with beauty, abundance, and grace and fertility. What Oshun definitely represents in the Orisha Pantheon. And with the Three of Swords here, with heartbreak, sorrow, and grief, I have a feeling that you have really healed from a lot of heartbreak and sorrow from the past. And now you're being able to move on. I also think it's interesting that we have the Four of Swords and the Three of Swords, particularly because we have this Three of Swords card and it's the last card. So it's kind of like this energy has lessened, right? Because it's the very last card. Whereas when we pull the first card, that's like the highest energy that is out. So I feel like, you know, you are ending this cycle of grief, of pain, of heartbreak, and you're coming into more of a beautiful abundant cycle that you have earned, pile number ones. I just really want you to know that, okay? And then with the Empress being a major arcana, this is like basically your overarching theme of life right now, is really indulging in luxury, really indulging in beauty, whether it's through your own beautification or other people who you deem as beautiful or abundance or graceful, or just even the scenery of nature, right? You could really be just overflowing with a lot of abundance and wealth and luxury and beauty in your life right now, okay? So congratulations in advance. We have three more cards. We have Mercury with Think, Learn, Network, and Communicate. There could also be a Virgo who wants to communicate with you. And if you don't subscribe to that, pile number ones, you could be more communicating like a Virgo now, because Mercury rules Virgo. And I have a feeling like you could be thinking a lot more critically and a lot more analytical in the best ways possible. Okay, and we have Neptune, dream and transcend. There could be some Piscean energy here, or some Yemaya, Cancerian energy here as well with Neptune. You could be having very intense dreams, or you could be dreaming of your life and how you want it to be, and those dreams are actually coming to fruition for you, pile number ones. And then our last card, which I love, the North Node, destined to have. And what did I say? You're destined to have the life of your dreams, pile number ones. This is what this means. And with Mercury here and Virgo and the Virgo card there, I have a feeling you have been not only dreaming up this life for yourself, but you've also been taking practical steps in order to achieve it. Okay. So our last card, and this is from the Magical Spell Oracle card deck. So let's reveal it. Wow. We have card number three with creativity. It says, by all above and all below, let me connect, let creativity flow. So I have a feeling also, pile number ones, there's going to be a lot of creativity just like swirling around you right now. We have card number 33. You could be seeing the number 333 a lot lately, which I feel is bringing in a lot of abundance and a lot of creativity your way. And 333 is a master teacher. So I have a feeling, because you're going to be able to materialize your manifestation, a lot of you all will be able to teach others how to materialize their manifestations as well. So if this is the case, pile number ones, what a fabulous reading. What a beautiful reading. You all deserve this abundance, this love coming in, this overflow that's going to be a continual steady theme for you, not just in the month of July, but probably beyond that as well, okay? So with that being said, my lovely dreamy dreamers, I'm so happy and blessed to have done this reading for you. If you like this reading, if you found any value in it, please give this reading a big thumbs up. Like, share, and subscribe. Share this content with loved ones, family, friends, or anyone who would best benefit from the messages provided here today. If you are interested in a beautiful, one-of-a-kind tarot journal, look no further. The link to this journal will be in the description box down below. It's only $20 and Amazon will ship it straight to your house, okay? So you can follow along and catalog these readings here on the Crazy Dreamer Network, as well as any other readings here on YouTube, okay? So only $20 and Amazon will ship it straight to your house, my dreamy dreamers. So I love you so much. And until next time, I will see you in your next reading. Bye. Hey, pile number twos, welcome back to your reading. So before we get into your crystal and pile selection card, let's shuffle your reading. So for those of you all who would like to skip this part, definitely do so. Your timestamp will be in the description box down below. I've already shuffled off camera, so let's begin. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for our pile number twos. Thank you, thank you. For the month of July 2023. Thank you. Thank you. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for our pile number twos during the month of July 2023. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for our pile number twos during the month of July 2023. Thank you. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for our pile number twos during the month of July, Spirit 2023. Thank you. And then one last card to end off your reading. This is a magical spell card. Last, clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for pile number twos during the month of July 2023. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right, pile number twos, let's get it. Okay, so we're gonna put your reading right here. Now let's get back into your crystal and your pile selection card. So for those of you all who chose this Tektite crystal, this message is for you. I'm gonna put it right to the side here. And I know Tektite is a good grounding stone, and it's really great for protection, especially when it comes to travel, as well as heart protection, I believe, when it comes to like getting over someone or something. We can kind of categorize those things as like a breakup, or like maybe even like losing connection to a friend, something like that. It will ground you enough to protect you during your travels, whether that's traveling away from someone or whether that's just, you know, organic travel, as in like vacation or moving, things of that nature. Okay, so let's get into your pile selection. So you all got two tarot cards here. Interesting. You have Temperance with the Six of Swords. So there is definitely healing and tranquility and moving forward when it comes to someone or something or a certain circumstance, pile number twos. Some of you all might be Sagittarius. I say that just because the Temperance card is here, but I feel like you are doing mental alchemy here, pile number twos, when it comes to moving away from something that just no longer serves you, okay? So we're going to keep both of these cards here. I just want to congratulate you all in advance. You're doing a very great job at staying balanced. Okay. So congratulations in advance. Okay. But let's get a better sense of things and uncover your Green Witch Oracle card. Okay. So we have grounding. I know I always give this disclaimer, but I never look at the cards other than the cards that come out face up, or intended to come out face up, but I never look at the cards that are face down until I reveal them to you all. And it's no surprise that, you know, you guys got a grounding stone. So it's a lot going on this card here. It's card number 5. So there could be a lot of change going on, or you can be you will be experiencing a lot of change, pile number 2s, during the month of July. But good change, mental change, almost like changing states of mind, so to speak, right? And I feel like you're doing so because you're being called to ground right now so that you can protect your energy. And I think it's interesting because we have the sun and the moon here. So I feel like there's a lot of things coming into integration for you, and a lot of things coming into harmony. And you all might find yourself pulling a lot of tarot cards or watching a lot of tarot videos here on YouTube to confirm your suspicions, to confirm what it is that you need to know at this particular time. I don't know if this is the Virgo or the I don't know if this is the Virgo or the Scorpio emblem, but I will find out for you all right now, because I do want to read a little bit from the book in regards to this message that you're being sent here. So let's see. So we have grounding with potato. It says, when the world wearies and society fails to satisfy, there is always garden. There is always the garden. So when the world wearies and society fails to satisfy, there is always the garden. Mini Almonier. It says, oracle meanings. Explore the deeper innermost areas of yourself and situations. As potato indicates, energies that are calling you to look again at what you may have once missed and will help to bring stability. If you are looking for an answer, try pulling back a little to let things settle on their own first. Challenges at the moment may include ignorance, self-centeredness, and forgetfulness. So make sure you are compassionate and focused, okay? So the astrological sign is Virgo, and it says celestial, the moon, the sun, so it's both. And then it says uses, image magic, healing, health protection, compassion, and stability. Okay. So I feel like a lot of you all are being kind of cleansed of worry right now through the way you alchemize your mind, body, and spirit, through the way you heal yourself, right? But you're definitely in a state of healing and tranquility, and your mind is being eased right now. So for some of you all, that Six of Swords could also be telling you that you could be traveling more too during the month of July, okay? But I feel like you're gonna feel very peaceful, very at a state of equanimity during the month of July, okay? So let's get your first 3 oracle cards. Come on, pile number 2s. We have card number 46 with a unicorn, okay? You are a magician. You are magic, friend. Magic is real. You believe in magic, and you make magic happen every single day of your life, even when you're not trying. I don't have to read this book to realize what the theme is here. So you are a magical being. You are a instant master manifester. That's all I'm gonna say. We have card number 17 with Lapidarite, very spiritual in nature too. So in the month of July, you could be having a lot of spiritual occurrences happen, a lot more than typically. And I feel like you could be also having like energetic and spiritual upgrades coming in as well with the Lapidarite crystal. Now we have our last card, and we have card number 22 with Rhodochrosite. Now this one I want to read to you guys, because I know rhodonite is a crystal of heart healing. So for those of you all maybe who have went through a breakup, or there could be, you know, just some type of heart healing, right? Like I said, you all could be aligning towards healing yourselves right now. But I do want to read to you this crystal, just because I know it's different than rhodonite, but it does have rhodonite in it. So let's see. Card 22. It says rhodochrosite. I welcome opportunities that lead to my heart's desires. Rhodochrosite can be found in variations of pink and brown with streaks of white that give this stone a unique appearance. Its connection to the heart chakra makes it a great companion to help open the heart and welcome positivity into your life. When it comes to making decisions in life, they are often categorized as being made with the head or the heart. You're being encouraged to welcome decisions that will lead to happiness and your heart's true desires. Find what speaks to you and what warms your soul, and let that be the choice that you make. If you're having a hard time discerning between your options, close your eyes and focus your energy towards your heart. Notice any subtle shifts when you weigh your options and listen to what your intuition and your heart have to say. Journal prompt. If I let it, where could my heart lead me? So grab your journals, guys. Those of you who have them and those of you who don't, go and get them. If not, grab a piece of paper. It's no problem. But write, if I let it, where will my heart lead me? Sometimes we're very afraid as humans, as individuals, to let our heart lead us because of that fear of heartbreak, because of that fear of the unknown, right? But I feel for you, pile number twos, you are really letting your heart lead you and then allowing your mind to discern right now, once your heart leads you, whether that's where you want to stay. Okay, so I love that for you. It's so beautiful. And, you know, I'm just happy that you're coming to conclusions and decisions that best fit your needs and fit what you want, you know, to happen. So let's get into your tarot. We have the Hermit, a lot of Virgo energy, a lot of healing, a lot of grounding, a lot of inner work. We have the Ace of Pentacles. So there's ample new opportunities coming in for you, pile number twos. We have the Hangman. Wow. You also have off that a lot of major arcanas. We have the Five of Swords. And we have the High Priestess. Very, very interesting. So off bat, we already have three major arcanas in a five card spread. We have the High Priestess, the Hangman, and the Hermit. So I feel like there is this rebirth coming in regards to really deliberating on what it is that your heart wants, what it is that your heart is calling you to do, or who it is that your heart is calling in for you. Just a brief moment, y'all. I am so sorry. There's a lot going on outside. I'm going to really try to fix the audio while separate from this, but hopefully you guys can't hear everything that's going on in the background. It's my neighbors, so please forgive me in advance. But again, so with the Hermit card, I have a feeling that like God, Spirit, Source, Energy is really just wanting you to kind of like go inside and really deliberate on the things that you want, or the things that you maybe have thought you wanted and have changed your mind with lately. With the Ace of Pentacles here, I feel like there is going to be an offer that's going to come in that you're kind of going to have to weigh the pros and the cons about, right? You're going to have to weigh like, okay, is that worth it? Is that worth it? Should I go here? Should I go there? Should I be with this person? Should I be with that person? Those type of things. And you might feel kind of stuck or stagnated while that comes in, right? But there's no need to fear, because during that pause or during that intermission, when you are going within, when you're kind of going through that Hermit mode, you're going to find the answers that you're seeking. Now, you might feel like there's some type of internal debate within you that's causing you a little confusion, but deep down inside, you know what to do. Okay, you know what to do, you know who to choose, and I feel like, again, the answers will be given to those who truly listen for them, okay? So during the month of July, pile number twos, there might be a lot of offers that you will get, and I feel like you're really going to take some time to yourself to weigh the pros and the cons and to deliberate on what offers are best for you right now in the season that you're in. Now, you may feel like, okay, someone might get hurt in the process, Unfortunately, that could be a potentiality, just regarding like maybe choices, maybe like let's say for example, you've been planning a vacation for quite some time, and then one of your family members really needs your help with something, but because you've been planning this vacation for so long, you can't help them. Their knee-jerk reaction might be to feel hurt or to feel like slighted or something like that. But ultimately, I feel like if you give it some time, your family member will come around and, think rationally like, well, they've been planning this for quite some time and this thing that I need to help with just occurred. So that's what I feel like the situation is here. There's going to be some offers. You're going to take some time to yourself to deliberate on the offers that best suit your needs and maybe the other people involved, right? The ones that are best correlated, best aligned. And you're going to make those decisions. And the knee-jerk reaction for some might be like, oh, this is unfair, or I wish they would have chose this, or I wish they would have chose me. But ultimately, they'll come around in regards to understanding. Okay, so I love that for you. So we have three more cards. We have four more cards, but we have three astrology cards. So let's see. We have House 10 with structure, discipline, life mission, accomplishments, and career. This could be a career choice that you could be making sometime soon that deep in your heart, your wisdom is telling you to probably go for with the owl depicted here. And then we have Taurus with trust, patience, and sensuality. So we have patience twice. We have patience with the temperance card here, because that's the crux of the temperance card, is being able to be patient and graceful, right? I felt like we have patience somewhere else, but I could be wrong. Oh, with the grounding card too, card number five. So we have three cards that depict patience. Spirit, God, source energy could either be calling you in more patience right now, more patience that's required, or what I'm getting is that something that you have been patiently manifesting or patiently waiting on will be manifesting in the month of July. But let's see our last astrology card. So we have Square, and it says a challenging situation and a mountain to climb. Okay, so there could be some challenges that come your way during the month of Taurus. Sorry, y'all. I don't know where my mind's at during the month of July, but I feel like the challenges that you'll be facing, you're already aware of. It's going to be a choice. It's going to be a choice that you really have to sit down for a while and really think through. So I don't think it's going to be too crazy, because I just feel like there's going to be a period of time where God, Spirit, Source, Energy really wants you to sit down, ground yourself. Maybe it might be for the whole month of July because something that you've been asking for is coming in. There's a potential offer here that's probably going to be, again, align with your life mission or your career. And I have a feeling you're going to really take heed and ground yourself and situate yourself so that you can make the best possible choice for yourself and anyone else involved. Okay. But again, so we have one last card, and this is from the magical spell card deck. So let's reveal it. We have card number 39 with safe home. I love this. I cast this circle around about safety now is beyond a doubt. Safe home. So some of you all could have been calling in a new home or wanting to feel more safe in your home or safe wherever you're at, where your possessions belong, something like that. I kind of want to read from the guidebook card number 39 with safe home. So 39, that's 12, 2 and 1, that's 3. So again, a lot of you all could be seeing the number 333. You could be seeing 369, 3. Three and nine. I say 369 because we have three and nine right here. And I just think about the 369 Tesla sequence. And then we have a 90-degree square with this astrology card too. But let's get into card number 39. And I will say this card was definitely chosen for you. So let's see. It says having. It says, having a safe home makes us feel secure and cocooned amidst the wildness of the world. It creates a nest to which we can fly and settle into in order to revive ourselves, nurture our loved ones, and be happy and be free. Excuse me. A happy, safe, and secure home lights up our life and enriches our relationships. Treasure and love your home with this protection spell. So yeah, I feel like you're calling in protection over your home, over your loved ones, a new home that you feel safe and secure in, because maybe you all have been growing out of your old home or something like that. But again, it says, if you were chosen by this spell, the universe is asking for you to take good care of the beloved safe space that is your home, to make it an oasis and to treasure the small and personal. Perhaps it is time to take the emphasis off the outside world and turn the energy we often spend on work or external places to our own environment. Cast this spell and become aware of the nurturing, healing magic of a safe, enchanted, and loving home. So a lot of you all could be called to ground yourself, ground your home, like this protection spell would suggest, to protect your home and to say a safe home spell. So you can say it by, I cast a circle around about safety now is beyond a doubt. So card number 39, I'll read the spell for you, but you all don't have to do this unless you feel that it's necessary. They ask for a lot. They ask to do a lot. But I'll just say this. Because they want you to draw a pentagram. No, it's too much. You guys could just say it and say it with passion and place emphasis on, you know, the intention you want to set. So you could say, I cast this circle around about safety now is all about nothing can enter here without my permission, clear and by the power of threes. Three times three, as I do, so mote it be. You guys could say that, make it your own, do whatever you want that gives the protection spell, the emphasis, the vibration of it, more feeling as you utter it, right? So yeah, pile number two's beautiful reading, very deep. It's time to go inside. It's time to listen to your inner self, because I don't think you've been able to hear for quite some time. But now that you can, because your mind is clearing, feel like spirit really wants to talk to you and just wants you to feel protected and safe in your surroundings, okay? So I love you so much, my dreamy dreamers. If you like this reading, if it resonated, please hit that thumbs up button, like, share, and subscribe. Share this content with loved ones, family, friends, or anyone who would best benefit from the messages provided here today. If you are interested in a beautiful, one-of-a-kind tarot journal, look no further. The link to this journal will be in the description box down below. You all can follow and track and archive our readings here on this channel, on the Crazy Dreamer Network, or any other tarot channel here on YouTube. It's $20, this journal is, and Amazon ship it straight to your house, okay? So I love you all so much, my dreamy dreamers. Again, if you guys like this journal, cop it. The link to this will be in the description box down below. I love you all so much, and I'll see you in your next reading. Bye. Hey, pile number threes, welcome back to your reading. So before we get into your crystal and your pile selection, let's shuffle for your reading. I've already shuffled off camera, so for those of you who would like to skip to your reading, your time stamps, look at that. Come on, y'all seen that? Your time stamps will be in the description box down below. So again, let's begin. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for our pile number threes, spirit. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for our pile number threes during the month of July 2023. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for our pile number threes during the month of July 2023, spirit. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for our pile number threes during the month of July 2023. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And one final magical spell card to conclude your reading with. one last clear, concise, accurate message for our pile number threes during the month of July 2023. Spirit, I'm feeling called towards this one. All right, pile number threes, let's begin. Is this, hopefully I'm doing this right, y'all. So we have your reading here. Now let's get back to your crystal and your pile selection. You all chose this beautiful sunstone, so fitting for the month of July. So for my Cancerians, I don't know why I'm just saying it, this pile, happy birthday to you all, love you lots. That could be a semblance for a lot of the Cancerian people watching this reading. Okay, so again, you all chose the Ten of Pentacles, so I have a feeling there's going to be a lot of abundance, a lot of time spent with family, friends, lovers, loved ones, people who are the most, who are the closest to you at this time. And I have a feeling you're just going to feel overcome with grace and love and abundance and compassion, and you're just going to love your life right now. Pile number threes is just what I'm getting. It's like the sun card. That's really what I'm getting. You're going to feel like this overall quality of your life, and you're going to feel like you have made the right decisions and you are now living in your dream life. You know, so congratulations in advance, my lovely pile number three dreamy dreamers. Okay, so let's continue on with your Green Witch Oracle card. Let us reveal it now. Come through, pile number three. That's what I meant. You're gonna feel victorious. You're gonna feel like you're living in your dream state. You go ahead, my loves. I love it. So you see this crown, and look, we have card number 44. It says victory. Okay, so there's Aries here, there's a crown. I love this for you, pile number threes. Congratulations in advance. I just feel like, yeah, you're just gonna feel victorious. I feel like you're gonna feel like you've made all the right decisions, even the ones that didn't feel so right, they turned out to be right. Card number 44, 4 plus 4, that's 8. That's infinite abundance. And then we have the Ten of Pentacles here, so that's like a double message with this infinite abundance here. Okay, but without further delay, let's read a little bit of what this 44 victory card wants to say. So the quote here, the plant is nasturtium. So it says, a garden is always a series of losses set against a few triumphs, like life itself. May Sartin. Very interesting. Oracle meanings. Nasturtium indicate a firm message of triumph and success over challenges, as well as support being found. They inject the energies of strength and vigor into all they come in contact with and illuminate ways to find resolution and gain self-confidence and self-reliance. Advancements is now possible, so get moving. Do not become obsessed with the need to impress others or lose your beliefs in your own unique abilities. So the astrological sign is Aries. The celestial sign is Marge. The deities, so the goddesses, are Brigid and Inti. And then the uses are success, support, vitality, independence, and optimism. I love this for you, pile number threes. You guys deserve it. I feel like you've been really working very hard on a life for yourself, and now it's about to come to fruition. Okay, so congratulations in advance. So let's get your three oracles right now. We have card number 19 with Obsidian. Beautiful. You're protected all the way, pile number threes. That's what that means. You're protected. Your Ten of Pentacles is protected. Your family, your overall life, your quality of living, it will be enhanced. Like, you go. Victory is yours. Okay, card number 19, Obsidian, 1 and 9. That's 10. Is again 10 10. You could be seeing the number 10 10 a lot lately, but this Obsidian allows you to know how protected you are mentally and spiritually and physically and on all of the realms. Okay, we have card number 5 with Eos. So some of you all, have unlocked a new level of your life, okay? Some of you all are really calling in the ability to really indulge in your luxuries and knowing that it's okay. It's okay to have desires, and you know, you have the key to your own beautiful dream life, and you are making it, and you have made it, okay? So I love that for you, pile number three. And last but not least, card number 53. Okay, sorry. Card number 53 we have is Leo, again, 5 and 3, again with the 8. So we have card number 8, technically speaking, 88. But like, all the riches of heaven and earth are being bestowed upon you now. And you could, this could have something to do, is Venus in Leo right now? I don't know, but Leo has been coming up a lot for a lot of different pick card readings, and it's just been coming up a lot. So I feel like you're feeling yourself, you're feeling confident, you're feeling vivacious, you're feeling like you could take on the world, pile number 3. So congratulations in advance. Use this Leo energy. Also, the 8-8 portal that's coming up in August could have something to do with all this abundance coming into you right now that you've been manifesting for quite some time as well. So keep an eye on that. And it's funny because we have 2 8s, 4 and 4, that's 8. And then we have 5 and 3, that's 8. So I'm getting that very strongly, pile number 3. So there's something with this 8-8 portal that is going to unleash all of your desires, okay? Whether it be before or after that 8-8 portal, okay? So we're gonna put this here. Let's get into your, sorry y'all. Let's get into your tarot for more information, okay? So we have the Star, dream come true. This is a dream that's coming true, pile number 3's. Congratulations in advance. We have guiding light, inspiration, faith, hope, miracles, infinite energy. I feel like that's what you've been praying for. Everything that you've been praying for, you've unlocked the key to the new life that was once a prayer. Okay. We have the Page of Cups. It says magic, love, and fun. I love this. So there's going to be an air of lightheartedness that comes in with your manifestations. And I feel like it's going to feel so good. You can feel like you'll be on the verge of tears. So cry if you need to. Definitely cry if you need to, pile number 3's, because I feel something magnificent that's about to happen in your favor. We have the Creator with no. Very interesting. Let's see the other cards. We have the 9 of Wands. And our last card is the Knight of Wands, okay? So I feel like there is going to be a dream made manifest, and it's going to be luminous. It's going to leave you with a light heart. It's going to leave you feeling very abundant and tranquil. And I have a feeling you might get some type of, you might get some like air of it in the month of July, or you might get notice of it in the month of July, something like that, pile number 3's. However, with this Creator card, so there's 2 yes and no cards in this deck. So it comes with 80, right? The yes is the Mother Star, so it's the counter to the Star. And then the no is this Creator card. There's also a Magician card in here as well. I have a feeling that you may have had to say no to something long ago in the past, right? This could have been the last 8-8 portal or 8-8 portal in the most recent past, right? So you could have had to reject, turn down something, or you could have been rejected and turned down for something in order to create a boundary within yourself and or create room for whatever it is that you've been asking for to come in. And with this Knight of Wands here, what I'm getting is, you know, in your intuition what that is. I feel like maybe whatever you had to say no to, you had to let go in order to have this like portal of your life be unlocked. I don't think it was anything crazy. It wasn't anything that you really wanted or, you know, really banked on being in your life or anything like that, or being in for the long haul. I do have a feeling that, like, it was protection. That no entry provided was protection. Although it felt sad in the beginning, maybe you've had to heal from it too. It sparked something in you. It sparked your intuition to know that, okay, you know what? Better is on its way. That's what I'm getting here. And I feel like you're going to get wind of this in the month of July, but the wish fulfillment, the Ten of Pentacles wish fulfillment that's coming in for you probably will happen in the month of August is what I'm getting. Don't quote me on the dates, because you know, y'all know time is fluid, but you know, that's just what I'm getting very strongly. And you guys know I don't usually say a lot of dates, but this pile seems more certain when it comes to the dates. But again, so let's get into your astrology cards. We have Sagittarius with optimism, exploration, and freedom. I love this. We have House 8 with transformation, karma, facing fears, and legacies. And it's interesting because Ten of Pentacles is a card of legacies, and then we have this card of legacies. So now the last card, we have Mars with move forward and defend self. So you might have to come to defense for yourself in the month of July. Okay, maybe at the end of the month, maybe at the beginning of the month, maybe in the middle of the month. You might have to come to defense to yourself, pile number threes. But I don't think it's going to be anything serious. I think whatever you might have to turn away or say no to, it's going to lead to a victory, or whatever you have turned away or have said no to in the past, you made a great decision because you're about to come up on this victory, okay? So our last card, okay, I did just peek at it on accident, but it's okay. Our last card from the magical spell card deck is card number 24 with magical powers. I weave and clear, I cast and know, magic secret to me now show. You have magical powers. Like, you're about to get like a energetic or spiritual upgrade coming in. This might happen on the 8-8 portal with the star Sirius, 2 and 4, that's 6. You could be seeing things manifest and take root now, but that's what I'm saying. Like, you're such a master manifester, pile number threes, that like people, I feel like you feel like, dang, I have magic. Like, I have magical powers here. So I feel like a lot of you all feel like I can manifest anything that I desire and decide. So I have to make sure what I desire and decide is good for everyone involved, because you're like an instant master manifester. I feel like, yeah, y'all see that? My refrigerator started running exactly as I said that. But let's read a little bit more into your last card. So it says card number 24, magical powers. Sometimes when we cast magic, we may be too caught up in the everyday to weave quite as much enchantment as we could if we were more in touch with our magical powers. This spell will help you reconnect with your magical self, and your spells will become more powerful, enjoyable, and enchanting as a result. If this magic spell card has chosen you, which it has, the universe would like you to reconnect with your intuitive, instinctual, mythic persona. Work this spell before performing any others, since without magical energy, it's difficult to weave true enchantment, to see the wonders of the moon, the glory of the sun, and the new beginning of the unfurling bud. And I think that's interesting, because in this, we have an unfurling bud, this victory. But you know how magical you are, pile number. We even have the crown here, and then we have purple, which is giving very crown chakra energy. So I feel like you guys know the magnitude of your power, and I feel like you are living proof of it. You're living in it. So kudos, pile number threes. Beautiful reading. Yeah, beautiful reading. I really don't know what else more to say. Please leave in the comments if this has already happened to you, if it's happened in the recent past, or if you feel like it's coming in the future, y'all. I would love to hear back from you guys in regards to this message in particular, okay? So with that being said, I love you all so much, my pile number threes. If you like this reading, if it resonated, please hit that thumbs up button, like, share, and subscribe. Share this content with loved ones, family, friends, or anyone who would best benefit from the messages provided here today. If you all are interested in a beautiful beautiful, one-of-a-kind tarot journal, look no further. The link to this journal will be in the description box down below. It is gorgeous and so whimsical and so fun. I've been writing in it so much, y'all. Like, that's why I have to be careful opening it. But anyways, $20, and you all can use this journal to archive readings on our channel or any other tarot channels on YouTube, okay? And they're really great to catalog some stuff. And trust me, you'll kind of wake up in the middle of the night and be like, I gotta pull cards, and this will be your handy duty companion, okay? It's only $20 and Amazon will ship it straight to your house, okay? And it'll help out the channel, so cop one. All right, you guys, I love you so very much, my dreamy dreamers, and I'll see you in your next reading. Bye. Hey, pile number fours, welcome back to your reading. So before we get into your crystal and your pile selection card, let's shuffle for your reading. For those of you all who would like to skip this part, the timestamp to your reading will be in the description box down below. I've already shuffled off camera, so let's begin. Clear, concise, accurate messages, spirit, for pile number fours during the month of July 2023. Thank you. Thank you and thank you. So someone's jumping to tell you something is what I'm getting. Someone or something. Clear, concise, accurate messages, spirit, for our pile number fours during the month of July 2023. Thank you and thank you. Clear, concise, accurate messages coming in for you during the month of July 2023, spirit. And last but not least, we're gonna just pull one of these magical spell cards to end your reading. Last clear, concise, accurate message for our pile number fours. That will conclude their reading. Thank you. All right, pile number fours. So let's get you set up and let's begin with your reading. We're gonna put your cards here. And again, let's begin. So you all chose the magnesite crystal. I believe this is magnesite. I could be wrong, y'all. I got this crystal ordering some tarot cards. No, I did not get this crystal ordering tarot cards. I got this crystal specifically for something, and I think I might have lost. Is this Penelope? This is the Penelith. So you all chose this Penelith crystal, and it's a stone of optimism and brings balance, which brings deep peace. It improves self-esteem and equilibrium. It protects and promotes love and for self and others, and it calms anxiety and purifies the mind, okay? So I don't know why I kept thinking this was another stone. It's Penelith. So excuse me, y'all, for the mix-up. Yep. So anyways, excuse me, guys, for the mix-up. So yes, this is your stone, the Penelith stone. Beautiful. It's lovely. So we're going to put your stone right here. Alongside, we have from the Gummy Bear Tarot with Death. And for some reason, this is one of the most, like, it's not scary because it's a gummy bear, but it looks pretty like it's an out there Death card. I feel like the regular Death cards don't even look that intense. So maybe you guys might be having nightmares, or like you could have been suffering from sleep paralysis or something like that. But here's a silver lining. when I was pre-shuffling for the pile selection cards, this card actually came in reverse. So I knew immediately it stood for rebirth. And I feel like maybe you all felt like this, like just felt like something was overtaking you, something that was just like outside of your control. And now you have some control back. Now there's this like rebirth and renewing and equilibrium, right? What the Penolith would suggest of your psyche, of your mind, body, and spirit, right? So you're gaining back that self-esteem, you're gaining back that clarity, and you're gonna feel very renewed because of it, okay? But now let's hop into your Greenwich Oracle Tarot and reveal what it's saying. So yeah, we have card 7 with passion. I love this Leo energy. I feel like your passion could be fueled, and that's what I'm getting with this rebirth energy when it came to the Death card here. I knew it was rebirth. I wasn't even worried or concerned about anything else. I immediately knew it was rebirth, so I thought it was funny that it came in reverse. So yeah, you guys are going to be feeling new passion for life, like a new lease on life. And I feel like you've been waiting for quite some time to get this like renewal of energy that you're about to claim here, okay? So yeah, without further delay, let's get into the first three cards of your reading. We have card 52 with Cancer. So for those of you all who are Cancers, happy birthday. Love my Cancerian folks out there. Card number 52 again with the sevens. Okay, so you all could be seeing 77 or the number 777 a lot more. You all could be kind of like digesting a lot of information or a lot of emotional feelings right now, okay, with the Cancerian sign here, okay? And there's a lot of water energy going because the Death card really does represent Scorpio for the zodiac portion of the tarot, but I digress. I feel like deep feelings are coming into play here. So let's see. We have card 2 with Benzatine. A lot of dark colors too already. A lot of deep, deep blues. Okay, so let's reveal your last card. And we have card number 49 with Aries, and then the sun. And then the sun came out. Okay, so I love this for you. So I know Benzatine is, she reminds me of the High Priestess card, okay, which would connote wisdom. Okay, and using your faculties, like really getting into your sacral energy when it comes to your creativity, that could really help right now. I feel like for those of you all who have cancer in your chart, in your natal chart, so some of you all could be Cancers, some of you all could just have a Cancer highly emphasized in your natal chart. I have a feeling that like doing something creative could really help to renew and reinvigorate your passion and your spirit for life, okay? So I love that for you. I want to read a little bit more information on card number 2 with this goddess card. I embrace my creativity. Like I said, I didn't even read this card before, but I knew it. So it says, pictured with the biwa, a traditional Japanese lute, Benzaiten is a Buddhist goddess of music, water, and knowledge. She is also known as the muse of all artists and innovators, and infuses inspiration into those who choose to connect with her. So the journal prompt, y'all, heart, is what kind of art would feel good to create? That's a really great question. Pile number four. So for those of you all who are Cancers or water sign, music could be a great art to maybe even collaborate with some people on. Even if you don't put it out there, you don't have to put it out there. You just create, you know? Not everything that we create has to be broadcasted, right? Unless you want to share it with the world or share it with people, then please do also. So let's get into your tarot, my lovely pile number fours. We have the 9 of Cups, beautiful, coming straight off the bat with wish fulfillment. I love that. And we have a cat here. So we know there's protection. We know there's joy. We know there's optimism coming in for you. So beautiful way to start your reading, pile number 4s. We have the 9 of Wands with strength, support, and boundaries. Yeah, I feel like you're protecting your happiness right now. You're really involved with like, I'm getting reinvention here. I'm getting like, yeah, reinvention. Like I'm protecting myself. I'm protecting my space. I'm protecting my boundaries. You know, we have the Five of Wands here. Internal, external conflict. We have the Two of Cups. Love this. And then we have the Six of Pentacles. So pile number four is, I think this is really great. I really do. I feel like, here's the thing. You're about to get a wish fulfillment here, right? You're about to reinvent yourself or reinvent the way you have been looking at a situation, perhaps with a spouse or a lover here. Or you could be making like a peace treaty with a lover in your life or a loved one. This doesn't even have to be romantic necessarily per se. It doesn't have to be romantic. I'm getting romantic, but it doesn't necessarily have to be romantic. Okay. What I'm getting here is that there's going to be reciprocity, after some challenging situation that you really had to place firm boundaries with, because if you didn't, it could have left you in jeopardy is what I'm getting, right? But you took the reins. You know, you maybe could have been, this is maybe where this frustration is lying, because you could have maybe done, you ever heard the, and I know it's maybe not PC to say now, but like beating a dead horse, like that's what I'm getting. That's what I'm getting with this anger here, because this person is very angry. It's like to no avail. I've tried, and like I'm not succeeding in something. So you maybe felt like, excuse my terminology, for lack of a better term, I don't mean to offend anyone and I would never do this, but beating a, you know, doing that, excuse me. But you know what I'm trying to say here, pile number four is that there's been something that's just left you kind of like high and dry. And it's like you've kept doing something and you kept repeating yourself to the point where you just had to make a decision to create boundaries, maybe with someone you were at odds with, maybe with someone that you were conflicted with in regards to allowing something to work, allowing someone to give you what you needed, right? And we have no major arcanas here other than the pile selection card here. So this could be about a breakup. It doesn't have to be, but this could be about a breakup or something like a passionate connection or reinvention. And I say breakup because we do have the Two of Cups here, and maybe something could have been conflicted, but this could be almost like a temporary setback is what I'm getting as well. Because, I don't know why I'm getting that. Like you had to really establish a boundary that maybe hurt when you did it, but it's leading you to someone who's going to give you everything you want or expect or require, whether that be in business, whether that be a friendship connection, whether that be in love, right? Or what I'm getting here also is that there's this temporary stalemate, this temporary breakup, which may or may not, or maybe break down with something, break up with a person, or break down in like a structure in order to kind of regroup and to make things more balanced. Okay, that's just what I'm getting, but it seems rather temporary because with the five cards here, all we have are minor arcanas, which talk about the day-to-day, which talk about not so serious things, right? So yeah, let's get into this astrology so we can kind of better see what's happening here. So we have water. This is definitely a watery situation. We have Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy. It says spirituality, emotion, and intuition and compassion. I feel like, again, a lot of dark blues, a lot of dark, like someone has been feeling their shadow self maybe a lot more lately. Their shadow aspect to their fluidity or their fluid nature. But I have a feeling that, you know, your intuition is running high right now. So if anything, go within, seek asylum from within, right? And then we have Scorpio, heavy emphasis on the Scorpio energy. Very, very interesting. So we have intensity, exposing, purging, and renewing. I told you guys I was getting that revamping, that reinvention energy. So you could be reinventing yourself. You could be for those of you all who resonate with the divine feminine, you could be using like some dark feminine aspects of your personality to gain what you want in life or to do things in a different way. But let's see, we have our last astrology card and we have trine. I love this. It says angelic support, harmony, and a perfect flow. So again, with more water energy. So the outcome to this situation is it's always darkest before the dawn, right? So I feel like whatever boundaries that needed to be placed with whom they needed to be placed with, there's a positive outcome coming in regards to this. I feel like maybe you've just had to say something one too many times and now like someone has gotten, they understand where you're coming from. So they're either going to change or God's spirit source energy is about to send you someone or a new opportunity that completely flips this situation on its head and gives you a beautiful harmonious outcome. Pile number four is okay, so that's gorgeous and I'm so happy for you. But again, to finish your reading, let us uncover your last magical spell card. And we have card number 23 with romance. It says romance, it is a sacred power, let it come to me this hour. So you're about to have a change in your romantic cycle. There could be a change for the better, I'm assuming. I feel like someone or something is coming in to balance things out where they have not been balanced before, pile number four. So congratulations in advance, because I feel like you've been calling this in and you've been really wanting this to come in for you. But let's read a little bit about the romance card. So it says romance, card 23. Romance is a necessary part of relationships. The magic of romance is that it can reconnect two people as mythical souls on a quasotic journey through life together. Everyone has to take care of their practicalities, but by inviting romance into our lives, we revere the power of two joining together, two intertwined souls and destinies in order for love to abound all around. Romance is one such way for this love to bloom stronger. It is not a foolish notion. In its noblest form, romance is the tending of the garden of love. Within myth, romance is a sacred power. It is legendary, enduring, and yet elusive for good reason. Enjoy the lavish romance this spell will kindle. You are a divine being, and this is a true romance. I love this. It says, if you were chosen by this spell, which you were, the universe is prompting you to invite some magic back into your life or relationship. Go to it. All else can wait until this spell has helped you recapture your divinity. Okay, I love that. So yeah, you could just say romance, and it is a sacred power. Let it come to me this hour. And just say it with all your heart and say it with all your might. Pile number four is because I feel like you all are in for something beautiful to occur. So there might have been a little friction, but I feel like the friction is definitely clearing up and you're going to feel this intensity of passion. It could be with a Scorpio, could be with a Cancer, could be with the Aries, could be with a water sign, Pisces, could be with anyone, but I'm getting a lot of water signs here. Okay, so I love that for you, pile number fours. And with that being said, I love you so much, my dreamy dreamers. If you like this reading, if it resonated, please hit that thumbs up button, like, share, and subscribe. Share this content with loved ones, family, friends, or anyone who would best benefit from the messages provided here today. If you all are interested in a beautiful one-of-a-kind tarot journal, look no further. The link to this journal will be in the description box down below, and it's only $20 and Amazon will ship it straight to your house, my lovely dreamy dreamers. You can use this beautiful journal and catalog these readings, so our timeless pick a card readings, as well as any other readings here on YouTube, personal readings, readings you do for family, friends, or yourself. You can catalog them in this journal. The link to this journal will be in the description box below. Again, it is only $20 and it will really help the channel, so copy yours today. I love you all so much, my dreamy dreamers, and until next time, I'll see you in your next reading. Bye.